called Liberty Leading the People, showing a strong, heroic woman leading a battle, arm raised in defiance. Another painting, Genius of Liberty, showed a man with a torch raised in one hand and a broken chain in another. And of course, there was the robed figure Libertas. She was ancient Rome's goddess of freedom. They all came together in my grand vision. I knew I wanted her to hold a tablet with the date of America's independence in one hand, and a torch in one hand, and a broken chain in another hand, a symbol of independence from tyranny and slavery. Wait, that's three hands. But I am Frederick August Bertoldi, after all. So I simply put the broken chains around her feet to represent her bold stride to freedom. Pretty clever, no? Well, the plan was for France to pay for the statue and America to provide the land and build a base and pedestal strong enough to hold her. Pretty fair deal, no? Well, it was for America. You got to keep the statue. However, the statue was well nearly finished when we discovered America was having difficulties raising money. Thankfully, a New York newspaper man named Joseph Pulitzer, a prize-worthy fellow and my dad, came to the rescue and helped generate enthusiasm to raise the funds necessary. Thousands of school children donated pennies back when a penny was worth a lot. Those little copper coins paved the way for this magnificent copper monument. As I sailed into New York Harbor, looking for the ideal vantage point for Lady Liberty, one look at Bellows Island, which later came to be known as Liberty Island, and I knew this would be her home. I could envision her majestically welcoming newcomers to this land of freedom. It would be 21 years from Michel Le Bollier's original suggestion to the grand unveiling in 1886. Okay, so we were 10 years late in delivering the statue in time for America's centennial celebration. These things take time. But isn't it remarkable that this incredible monument ever happened at all? You should have been here for the unveiling. It was magnifique. I was the proudest papa in all the world. And my dream became a symbol of hope and freedom for millions to come.